Yo, what up? This the out of control podcast.
DJ 91.
Y'all ready for a new episode? Enjoy the show.
Stay focused, man.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
Podcast Poppy, 91 Podding. Came here for the news cause they know what's popping. Discovering new artists cause they know what's dropping. We be cleaning out the buckets, better know what's mopping. Figured I would stop in for an hour and a half. Pour some fire in the glass, fly our fires, have a laugh. Tapping, they be really knowing what's happening. Check out their reactions cause they knowing what's slapping. Groovy, they knew my tunes before you even knew me. Now groupies, all in here and we about to film a movie. It's all great, been in line all day, now I'll wait. I came here for the ride because of mayhem, no all state. Don't at me with bullshit, ignore me, don't at me. This my track and my race, so you know I'm lapping. I hit and run like I'm crashing, she don't put it past me. A Scooby just looking for Daphne. It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
This the out of control podcast.
DJ 91.
Y'all ready for a new episode? Enjoy the show.
Stay focused, man.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
Podcast Poppy, 91 Podding. Came here for the news cause they know what's popping. Discovering new artists cause they know what's dropping. We be cleaning out the buckets, better know what's mopping. Figured I would stop in for an hour and a half. Pour some fire in the glass, fly our fires, have a laugh. Tapping, they be really knowing what's happening. Check out their reactions cause they knowing what's slapping. Groovy, they knew my tunes before you even knew me. Now groupies, all in here and we about to film a movie. It's all great, been in line all day, now I'll wait. I came here for the ride because of mayhem, no all state. Don't at me with bullshit, ignore me, don't at me. This my track and my race, so you know I'm lapping. I hit and run like I'm crashing, she don't put it past me. A Scooby just looking for Daphne. It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control, out of control.
This the out of control podcast.
DJ 91.
Y'all ready? Y'all, Y'all ready for a new episode? Let's go. Enjoy the show.
Stay focused, man.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know my favorite show.
Out of control.
It's the weekend and you know the place to go.
Out of control.
It's the weekend, all the ladies gotta go.
Out of control.
Podcast Poppy 91 Podding. Came here for the news cause they know what's popping. Discovering new artists cause they know what's dropping. We be cleaning out the buckets, better know what's mopping. Figured I would stop in for an hour and a half. Pour some fire in the glass, fire fires, have a laugh. Tapping, they be really knowing what's happening. Check out their reactions, cause they knowin' what's slapping. Groovy, they knew my tunes before you even knew me. My groupies, all in here, and we about to film a movie.
We recording for real?
And we're back!
Let's go!
Let's go!
First episode of April!
And we are back!
April 2nd. Yeah, I almost
April
said
1st.
I almost April said Fools. April 1st, April Fools, but nah. It's April 2nd.
April
we
Fools.
Recording the first hour
Get
of the day.
Get my motherfucking podcast out your fucking mouth.
Don't listen to him. We need y'all to keep it in your motherfucking mouth and spread the word.
No homo, though. No homo.
Ain't nothing homo about that.
Sir,
you said podcast.
The arm
nothing
is,
else.
The arm of the thing's in the way.
Oh, well, which one? Oh, yeah.
Mine.
Yeah.
Should be okay.
Yeah, it's all good. Yeah. It's all good. Either way, it's all good. I don't really care.
I don't really care.
But yeah,
really
142, care. We back, y'all.
142.
It's still fucking cold outside, but that's what's expected when you live here in Canada.
There were snow flurries this morning, my guy.
Yeah.
Snow flurries, my guy.
I even see the snow flurries earlier this morning. I think maybe, did it happen like in the morning, like before noon? Because like I even
no,
see.
No, it was way before. I think it was like 10-ish.
Tennis. Oh yeah, yep. Yeah. I was still asleep at the time. I told y'all last week I wasn't coming into work on Friday.
And he went to work on Friday.
Oh yeah. Oh no. Not to what? Listen, Carrie. Something I prefer doing.
Yes, I know.
Yeah, I know.
Like being on Craigslist.
Yeah. Oh no. That's for you, not me.
Man said that's for me.
You said Craigslist like it's your hobby or something.
Yeah, it's my job.
What, you're a podcaster on Craigslist?
Sure am.
Yeah.
After hours?
It's definitely podcast, after hours right now.
Podcast after dark.
Yeah.
You know, but, BT after dark?
Oh yeah, I remember one of them ones.
Back in the day.
Yeah. But I have a funny story to tell you at work. You're one of the guys who I call Sean Paul, by the name of Paul.
Oh, the guy at work?
Yeah. The brown man who works in the freezer who told me about, you know.
Yeah.
He got fired.
Say a word. What do you do?
Yo, because dog, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, he's not showing up to work. And
he's temp or full-time?
Oh, he's full-time with the company. Like he's worked with them on and off, right?
Yeah.
So this is second time coming back to the job, but he hasn't been coming in lately. And plus, you know how when you don't show up to work, you're supposed to call in and tell him, yo, I can't make it, and tell him blah, 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 reason why he can't make it. He hasn't been doing that. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, he hasn't been showing up to work and he hasn't been calling in. So Thursday, when he shows up, he shows up 2 hours late, right? While we're in a meeting.
2 hours late?
Yeah.
No way.
Man just shows up, not even at least call in saying you're going to be late. You should call in if you're not going to make it.
So he just says hi when he walks in?
No, he just walked in like nothing, you know, while we're in a meeting. You know?
And, why are you guys having to meet in 2 hours?
Because no one really makes it on time.
Oh,
because
me,
I show up late. I don't give a fuck. Because it's all these overtime hours you have us working, I'm not going to come in on
time.
So
what time is your actual shift?
7 to 3:30. But y'all have us working way past 3:30. So it's if we don't finish on time, I'm not going to come in on time.
So you just tell them you're coming in late?
Nope.
Not anymore,
I just come in 20 minutes late. I don't give a shit, bro. If we finish on time, I'll come in on time. Otherwise, I'll keep being late.
Exactly.
Especially till the day I quit.
You already gave him the 2 weeks, no?
Of course. I gave him my 2 weeks Tuesday. Oh, yeah. Just give it in writing.
But you did?
Yeah, I did. I made sure I did that, yeah.
Like, I threw my supervisor off guard. He's just like, oh, are you? You're giving in your 2 weeks? And I'm like, yep.
Yep.
Yeah, yo. Legit, had enough of that place. And I'm going to start, I'm going to go, like I said, part-time these final 2 weeks, yo. I'm not going to keep showing up every single day. I'm tired of it, bro.
This is your second last week, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Like, yes. Next week, after next week, Monday, Tuesday is the last 2 days.
Maybe.
But you like I said,
Friday's the last day.
Oh, no, I'm shortening my weeks, bro. I'm not working any more Fridays.
Mr. Shorty over here.
I don't know who you're talking. I don't know why you're talking about Mr. Shorty.
Mr. Shorty by shorting up your weeks.
Yeah. Oh, that's what you meant.
That's what I meant by.
You just had to clarify. But anyways, yeah, yo. Okay, so he comes in 2 hours late, right?
Yeah.
And after the meeting is done, like the boss was doing the meeting.
Yeah.
Like one of the bosses, like he's giving us some coupons for free Slurpees at 7-Eleven, right?
Okay.
So, yeah, so Paul, the guy who comes
he
in 2 hours.
Comes up to get the free Slurpee?
Oh, no, like he's like, while they're getting passed around,
yep.
He's getting offered one. He's like, no, thanks. I'm good. Because he overheard him talking about like the employees here not getting a raise because of money being lost from damaged products, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's because I know, because like, you know, that affects, you know, the money for the company to give them a raise. So I think he got angry about that. And then after the meeting and when we're on the floor, after break time, like we go for our break after the meeting and then come back on the floor.
Yep.
He talks to me like, yo, not Paul, not the boss, Paul. He tells me like, yo, did he just fucking say no raise till 2023, dog? Did he just say that shit? Yo, I'm fucking pissed, dog. Yo, I'm supposed to be getting a fucking raise. What?
But if it was a raise, how much do you think it would be?
Oh, no, like no, because for his department, he picks in the freezer, right?
No, but I know.
Yeah.
But I'm saying like, but like how much would a raise be?
Just a dollar. Just a dollar. Yeah, but like for his department.
No, it should be more than a dollar.
They should be getting 18 while the rest of us is, while all of us are getting 17.
Yeah.
Yeah, so like. He's getting mad over that shit, right? He's like, yo, these guys are fucking pissing me off. Not giving me my fucking $1 raise. I pick and freezer. What the fuck? It's like, yo, I should give him my 2 weeks, bro.
Give him a 1 day, bro.
Yeah.
Man hit up said, fuck the 2 weeks. I'm giving you a 1 day. I'm out of here.
Yeah, but
that's
like,
it.
But the funny thing is like, yo, doc, he hasn't given his 2 weeks. For the past like month and a half, he's saying like, yo, I'm a quit. Yeah, he's still here. And he's not showing up here and there, not calling in. Okay, so
yep.
Check it out. It goes like he's
check
mad.
Check it out. 1, 2.
Yeah,
one,
he's
two,
mad about
check.
That, right? Okay, so
yep.
One of the managers, she gives us a good deed by making us lunch. You know, she makes us, you know, chili and beef hot dogs, right?
Yeah, yep.
Had some of the beef hot dogs. It was good. We come in. The guy, Paul, comes in. He's upset and whatever. Oh, I'm good. I don't want any.
I don't want that. I want my dollar raise.
Yeah, that's what he said. He's
fuck,
like, yo.
Fuck the chili dog. I want my dollar raise, guys.
He's like, yo, I'd rather
stop
starve.
Stop feeding me.
He's like, I'd rather starve. It's okay. Like, after the manager offers him some food, like, I'm good. I'd rather starve. I don't want any lunch. Oh, we ain't getting a raise, but we get lunch. Blah, blah, this and that. So as Sarah asked him, like, yo, again, like, yo, you okay? You want some food? He's just like, no, I want a raise. I want a raise.
Oh, fuck, don't kill. What the?
Oh, wait, what happened? We still recording?
Nah.
What?
Fuck.
Oh, what?
Nah, we're going to have to go again.
Start again? Okay.
It wasn't recording you properly.
Oh, shit. Oh.
Yeah.
Dang, good thing you caught that, bro.
I thought I put record for both for some reason. But
oh, no, it's all good. At least we never went a whole hour.
That's what I'm wondering. I'm like, why do I only hear myself?
Oh.
That's all good. We fucked up on the live, but.
Sure. It's all good, bro. It's all good.
You can tell a story again.
Yeah, I'll retell the story.
Okay. My bad, yo.
No, it's all
as
good.
As long
bro.
As we didn't do the whole pod like that.
Yeah. Then that would have been a whole waste. That would have been a whole waste of time.
Yeah. I'm like wondering. I'm like, I don't hear you in my ear, bro.
Yeah. Good thing you have the headphones on to know.
Whenever you're ready.
Yeah, start. Enjoy the show. Okay, now we good.
Now we are officially back up and running.
Episode 142, dog.
Again, this is 142, part two.
Take two, action.
Take two. Do we have to take a take three? Let me check. Nah. No,
good. It's
we
recording
don't.
Both of us.
It's recording.
Yeah.
Get Get the podcast out your fucking mouth.
Yeah, we had to start over because it wasn't recording me at first, but luckily you caught that, yo.
Yes.
Okay, so.
Yo, my boy, Kyle, what's going
on? Oh, that's
on?
Kyle. Yo, what is up, yo? Just in time to hear us recording for real this time.
I just added you on the thing on Twitch.
Yeah.
So it should be good now. My guy, we fucked up for the first 5 minutes. It wasn't recording Cade. Now it's recording.
Yeah.
We are back.
Yes, sir. April 2nd as we're recording this.
April 2nd. So, April Fools.
Yeah, which was yesterday.
Yes. Yes.
What should be, they should come up with, what's good, boys? Yeah, we good. Yo, we good. We doing
what's
the pod right
chilling.
Now.
Chilling.
What's
chilling
good with you,
Kyle?
Chilling
in the podcast room, fam.
Yeah.
What's going on,
which
my
is
guy?
AKA the basement.
The basement. This is Rap City, the basement.
Yeah. Yo, Kyle, you want to hear a story? I'm about to tell this story, yo, about how one of my coworkers got fired just for throwing a fit over not getting a dollar raise. Cause like, yo, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, he's not showing up, he's not calling in.
Yep.
Thursday, he shows up 2 hours late without calling in. While we're in a meeting, after the meeting, manager offers us a coupon for free Slurpees at 7-Eleven, right? But Paul refuses, the guy's name is Paul, right? He refuses the coupon from the boss because he overheard the man talking about, we might not give you guys raises for next year because we're losing money for damaged product, right? So we go for break, and then after coming on break on the floor, Paul comes up to me saying like, yo, did this guy say fucking bro, we ain't getting no fucking raise till next year? Yo, I'm fucking pissed, dog.
I should
be getting a dollar raise. What the fuck? What the fuck?
The fuck, man? I don't want no Slurpee. I want my dollar raise, homie.
Because for his department, they should be getting 18 an hour, but they're getting 17. No,
but if you're working a freezer, some other jobs pay you like more than $20.
Yeah,
like 20
at least,
bucks.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, bro, $1 raise?
Yeah.
And they're giving away free Slurpees, bro?
Yeah.
You can make your own Slurpee in your department. Bro, bring your own Slurpee to work day.
And like, yo, okay, so we go for lunch. One of the managers gives us food, right? We have lunch.
Man said, fuck his chili dogs, fam.
Yeah, yo. The beef hot dog slaps still, though. I had them with some barbecue sauce.
Yeah.
Minus the chili.
But your boy Paul said, fuck the chili dogs.
Yeah.
I want my dollar raise.
Yeah, manager offered him the food. He's like, no, I'm good. I'd rather
starve.
No,
I'm good.
And as he's trying to talk to him, he's just like, you sure you don't want any food? No, it's all good. I'm good. So what
That's
is it
good.
That you
it's
want?
Good.
Oh, I
I'm
want
good.
A raise. I want a raise. Still showing attitude over the raise or whatever.
Man needs that raise.
And the manager is just like, yo, dude, you know what I'm trying to do for you guys, right? Like, I appreciate you guys and whatever, you know? Like, if you want to talk about the raise, talk about it with the bosses, you know? And it's a little dialogue here and there, you know? So, yeah. So, okay, after that, he goes on the floor. He's not doing anything. And I heard he was trying to, you know, go into the office, look for the bosses, but they're in a meeting.
For what?
Just to talk about the $1 raise.
Yo, I need that $1 raise, fam.
Yeah. And like,
give everybody else the food. Don't give anybody else the raise. Just give me the raise.
And he's still heated from that. So he's going back on the floor. He's supposed to be picking, right? He's just walking around not doing shit. So the bosses and the supervisor from my department, they go on the floor. They confront him. I see it walking out the washroom. Yeah, like, oh shit.
He's picking his own raise. Not picking orders. He's trying to pick his own raise.
I have a feeling how this is going to end. And then, like, from a distance in my aisle where I was picking,
walked him to the front door type
yo,
thing?
Yeah, they walked him out. Like, I see him taking off his safety strap, taking off the scanner, and going to the locker room, putting away this shit, and they're walking
him
out.
He's like, fuck, finally, bro. Fuck, do I still get a raise on my way out?
And yeah, and I think they fired him on the spot.
Wow. Because
I heard that, you know, by the front door, one of the bosses yelled at him because he was talking some shit.
That's good.
Yeah.
You need that raise, fam. You got freaking people to feed, my guy.
Yeah, but don't get me wrong. He's my guy, but it's like, yo, bro, the entitlement.
Numbers?
When
you still have his, like, his number and shit?
I have his number. Been trying to call him, text him, no response. He has no voicemail.
That or he just can't pay his phone bill right now.
Yeah.
Because he needed that dollar raise, my guy. He needed that dollar raise.
But the funny thing is, from time he's been saying like, yo, I'm going to quit this shit and find something else.
Well, now's his time, my guy. That's
He should have sent in his 2 weeks just like I did. I sent my 2 weeks Tuesday and I took Friday off. I took today off, bro. Fuck coming in another Friday. I've been wanting, like I said, I would still quit that shit even if I wasn't moving. But yeah, yo, it was, he kind of screwed up. Sometimes you got to be professional.
But you know? Still, that's a funny way out, though.
Yeah, yo, legit.
Man, like, got it into an entanglement at work.
What entanglement? Entanglement with anger. You with mean anger. An arrangement, not entanglement. That's the wrong
anger
word.
Anger management.
Not for this. Work. Not for this story. Ain't nobody entangling with no coworkers. Fuck that.
Who knows, my guy?
Not no.
Who
not
knows? Me. Not at your place.
No, not at any place. I would never try. I would never try. You know, get with a coworker. Fuck that shit.
Fuck that shit. Because Kate already tried it.
Me? No, I never tried
I'm
it.
I'm joking.
Yo, but the funny thing is, there was a coworker that stole from me.
Stole from you?
Yeah, female coworker.
Stole what?
Money.
From where? Your bag?
No, like, yo, this girl, okay, check it out. Another story.
Check it out. Another one.
We gonna get another to the content one. Later. Yeah, I know. We gonna talk about what we're gonna talk about. But here, my story.
Fuck the content. I'm here for story time.
Yeah.
Chapter one.
So, okay, so this is like in the beginning when I first started the job, right? There's this girl, 19 years old, right? She comes up to me. Ask me like, oh, what favor would you do or not do for me, right? And I'm like, what do you mean? She's just like, I just need some money to help me buy a dress or whatever. So I'm like, okay, how much you need? I'm like, she needs like just $50. I need it for 72 hours, just for a few days. So I'm like, okay, sure, I'll send you the money if you need it, and I won't be on your ass about it as long as you pay me back within a timely manner, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we exchange numbers just for her to text me the bank e-transfer email, right?
Yeah,
we don't do Cash App up here in Canada.
Yes.
We do e-transfer.
E-transfer me, dog.
So, yeah, I send her the $50. After a week passes, she ain't pay me back.
She ain't pay you back or she didn't show up to work?
No, she showed up to work, but I kindly reminded her saying like, yo, if you need more time to owe me back, it's okay.
And let me guess. Okay.
She's just like, okay.
Okay, Kate, stop asking, Kate.
Yeah. Okay, so a few more days pass after that, right?
Yep.
And plus like, yo, I noticed that she's no longer there. And a week from the day she was no longer at work, I'm like, wait a minute. Why is she not here? What's going on? I asked the assistant supervisor.
Yep.
Yo, she got fired. That's what he said. And I'm like,
what was the reason why?
For stealing.
Stole from work.
Yes, because they brought it up in a meeting like, yo, somebody's been stealing. We know who it is.
But what are they stealing from work?
Money. And shit like that.
But money from where, though?
I guess from like cash from like another coworker's locker.
Oh, you guys don't have locks on them? Or is she sharing a locker?
Oh, no. There's no locks on them. Some have lockers. Some don't have lockers.
You can't put your own locks on it?
Oh, yeah, you can.
Well, you have to.
Yeah.
Well, you don't?
But still, you shouldn't be stealing from your coworkers regardless.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, so she stole money. And not just that, the bitch was mooching off of other people at work, having them buy lunch for her and shit.
Fuck
right?
that, bro.
Yeah, it's like, yo, you're working. Why are you making people buy food for you and borrowing money from them? That don't sound right. You're trying to take advantage of people's kindness. So, yo, I find out
that's mostly all females too, you know.
Yep. Yo, take it like yo, this was she was of Nigerian descent. So
there you know? Go. That's yes. That's strike number one.
Yeah, young and of Nigerian descent. So yeah. I'm like, I wasn't interested in all. I was just being a nice guy.
Yeah.
You know? But then okay, so I find out about that, like, bro, that she got fired for stealing and she ain't paying me back. And I didn't even hear from her. And I was
still to this day nothing.
And I was so pissed off, bro. I was so mad. I'm like, yo, this fucking bitch. Yo, and I have her number. I texted her like, yo, saying you don't pay people back when you owe them money, huh? And she's trying to be all defensive and shit, saying
I paid you back.
I did. And like, oh, I noticed you got fired. You got fired for stealing? Oh, please. That's so stupid. Like, you know, I didn't even call her a bitch.
Where's your phone? Let me call her a bitch. You're a bitch.
I was just teaching her a lesson like, yo, you shouldn't be doing this. You shouldn't be stealing from your coworkers.
Yeah, but you should still give my man his $50 back.
Exactly, bro. You know, like even my assistant supervisor told her, like text her saying like, yo, give back the man his money. And she's being all defensive, making up excuses. Like, I didn't get fired. I had to leave and go to school. And whatever. I needed the money for school.
Okay, but you still got money to give Kate his $50.
Oh, please, whatever.
So give him his $50.
Yeah, she's just like, and I'm like, oh, that's just BS. Like, I know you're lying. You're just teeth and whatever, you know? You're just like, oh, off my line. I'll pay you back when I feel like it. When I feel like it? What you mean by when I feel like it? You're supposed to pay me back.
She said when you feel like it?
Yes, talk about I'll pay you back when I decide to pay you back. When I decide to pay you back? Really? And I'm like, okay, whatever, keep the money and whatever. Just like, oh, I don't want you to pay me as negative, blah, blah, this or whatever. I'm like, okay, fine, whatever, take the money. And that was it. You're not getting another dime from me again. So, yeah.
And the next day he sends another 50 bones. No, I'm joking.
Nah, fuck that shit. Joking, I'm so joking. That's, make this be a moral of the story. Don't trust your coat. Like, and don't trust somebody that asks you to, you know, ask to borrow money from you at work. Don't lend coworkers any money, you know? So, yeah, because it's like, bro, we getting the same wage, same salary, and I got more bills to pay than you are, than you do. So
I have to go to school.
Yeah, I left because I had to go to school. Oh, please, bullshit. It's like, yo, dog, I wasn't born yesterday. This a Gen Z trying to fool a millennial. Oh, please.
Oh, please.
this someone born 2002 trying to fool someone like me.
Next time, don't give out money, my guy.
Yeah. Well, she stole. It wasn't just me. She stole from other people.
No, I know. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Just saying.
I know. Yeah. I know. Yep. I won't. Anytime a stranger asks me
Yo,
for money.
Yo, K-Dog. Nope. You still here, K-Dog? Yo, K-Dog.
K-Krillo 10.
K-Dog, you still here, K-Dog?
K-Krillo 10.
K-Dog?
Or K-Cirillo 10.
Earth to K-Dog.
Oh, yeah, that's what you call him for real? His nickname, K-Dog?
It is now. K-Dog.
That used to be my nickname, but I retired
but now you're
that
MC
shit.
Kit Kat.
Me? Nah, I retired that from time. I don't even do the rap thing no more. So, yeah, yo, let's get to the content.
Of
course,
content.
Yeah. What people have been talking about all week long. The slap heard around the world. Don't you dare. You want me to slap you, bro?
Slap the man, them.
This guy. We'll put your dirty hand on my face.
Not dirty, man.
I know. You did it
hand
for...
Hand sanitizer, my guy.
Did you actually sanitize your hands?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Oh, please. Yo. So, like, where were you when you saw it?
At home.
Same.
My mom was watching it.
Yeah.
And then she's like, Matt, what happened on the Oscars? I'm like... The Oscars is on? I'm like, what? I'm like, okay. And then it was on live, obviously, right?
Yes.
So she's like, why'd it go muted? I'm like, I don't know. Maybe he said something.
Yeah.
And then 5 minutes later, the Japanese version came out.
Right? Yes.
I think it was the Japanese
version. Japanese version, yeah.
Yep. Because they were doing the subtitle. Like, they were showing it in Japanese.
Yeah.
But the English was still playing in the background.
Yeah, you still hear the English over the Japanese dub.
So that's when I heard Will Smith, get my motherfucking wife's name out your motherfucking mouth.
Yeah. You hear the uncensored English
one.
Audio.
But on
the
national
live
TV down here,
yeah.
it muted.
It was muted.
I'm like, yo, like, what's wrong with my TV, bro?
Yeah. Yo, the funny thing is, because like, yo, I thought.
No, but the only thing I don't get
was
when I first seen it.
Yeah.
Because when Chris Rock told the joke,
yeah,
he was laughing.
Yeah.
Like Will Smith was laughing.
Yeah.
Jada was like, wasn't really like.
She didn't like it. She rolled her eyes.
Yeah. But she wasn't like people say, oh, she was crying at the joke.
Yeah.
She was rolling at the eyes. Okay, cool. Just basically get over the joke and blah, blah, blah. Move on, right?
Yeah.
And then do you see freaking like Will Smith like walk up?
Yeah.
Bro, the way he was walking up.
Yeah. Bro,
they were still laughing at each other.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm like, he goes up. I thought he was gonna like stand beside him, and I don't know what the hell was gonna happen. I'm like, so okay. So they just let him get off the seat.
Yeah.
Walk up, hit the man in his face.
Will Smith, you slap like in Pokemon.
Or like Yu-Gi-Oh. I choose the you play like the card in your deck.
The slap card.
And then, so I'm like, okay. But, and then Chris Rock is just like standing there, like waiting to get hit. So I'm like, okay, is this fake?
Waiting
this
to
real?
Get hit? I don't think he expected
that. Bro, he
that.
Leaned into the slap. If you watch the video, man's like this. Okay.
Yeah,
like
that's
he's leaning in like this, right?
That's what the conspiracy theorists are saying.
Bro, I'm not even saying that. That's how it is in the video. He's like, I'm not saying he's like leaning in a lot.
Yeah.
By the way, like when Will Smith slapped him, it looked like Chris Rock was just. Obviously, just standing there.
Yeah.
But the way that he was hunched over made him look like he was leaning in.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay. And then after he got slapped, they're still laughing at each other.
Yeah.
So I'm like, What the fuck's going on? Is it fake? Is it real?
Yeah.
I got messages from my brother. Yo, did you see this? Did you see this? Is this real? Is this fake?
Yeah. It was definitely debatable at the time.
But in the beginning, before he started swearing, because I didn't hear the swearing part.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's fake. Because they're both laughing even after Chris Rock got hit.
Yeah.
And he's like, wow, best moment of TV history of all time.
So you believe the whole thing's fake?
Well,
Or at the time.
At the time.
Yeah.
At the time, before I heard the cursing.
Yeah.
And then he didn't say her, he's like, wow, dude, is a G.I. Jane joke.
Yeah.
Come on, dude.
Yeah.
And then that's when he snapped fucking again.
Yeah.
And then, get my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
He said that loud and slowly.
And then again, get my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
And then it was a little bit of awkward silence for a second.
And then he's like, okay, dude.
I will.
Yeah.
And then, you know.
And I'm like, but it would have been funny if Chris Rock said, if this is how mad you get in March, how mad do you get in August?
Oh, Lord of mercy, God. If he said that. Oh, my gosh, bro. There would have been no comeback for that.
Now that would have been awesome.
Yo, that would have totally ethered the hell out of Will,
yo,
bro.
Snip that part, my guy.
Oh, yo, I'm definitely going to snip that. My goodness, bro.
Yes, I'm surprised you got that in the first take. Usually when I say stuff, it goes over your head first.
Oh, no, not that.
Nah, better not.
Yeah, if it
yo,
ain't
yo, there were so many memes, bro.
Yeah, of course, bro, definitely. Most memeable moment ever in history.
Friggin' that, and then they had the picture of them standing up before he's getting slapped.
Yeah.
And they put, what was it? Everybody Hates Chris.
Yeah.
I was dying.
Yeah, yo, and you see, what's it called? Like, Marty the Zebra from Madagascar, which was voice acted by Chris Rock.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the fish from Shark Tales, voiced by Will Smith. You see this? You see the fish slapping the zebra. The animated meme. I'm like, holy bro, whoever did that is genius.
Yeah, because first of me believing it was fake in the beginning.
Yeah.
Because the Oscars has been dead for a while.
Yeah.
Because Jada,
I didn't even care without that.
That's what
on.
I'm saying.
I didn't even
then
know.
Jada was boycotting it because Will Smith wasn't nominated.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Or whatever. And then Chris Rock didn't want to be the host, and then he was the host.
Yeah.
And Jada said, yeah, man, you could be the host. That's all you. Like, you already know. I thought like Jada and freaking Chris Rock were like close type thing, you know?
Yeah, but you heard, what's it called? You saw that clip of what Chris Rock said in 2016 with Jada Pinkett saying like, oh, her boycotting the Oscars is like, me not being in, me boy, me and something, Rihanna's panties.
Yeah, me,
I wasn't invited. Whatever it was.
He's not lying. I'm not saying like, okay, but that's not as bad as the G.I. Jane joke.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You thought the G.I. Jane joke was terrible, was bad, shouldn't have been said, uncalled for.
Well, I don't know. To me, like I got into an argument with Brandon too. He's
really?
Like, you should never go after like a person's family. Like, bro, Chris Rock is a comedian.
Yeah.
If anyone's sitting in front of him, that's a comedian's job. Yep. Even if to go off script and make fun of you till the end or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't mean anything by a comedian.
And plus, did he even know about Jada's alopecia?
I heard he didn't know.
Exactly. So if he didn't know, then it's not really his fault.
If he did know that,
then yeah,
I'm pretty sure he didn't even write that joke.
Exactly.
I heard it was...
I heard he didn't write that joke.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But... Like, I know that, he still said it.
Yeah.
But he probably thought it was funny.
Yeah.
Will Smith actually laughed at it.
At first, yeah. But it might have been like a passive-aggressive laugh. Because it's like, oh, okay, you're laughing about my wife's medical condition. Okay,
no, but
okay.
He still looked like he was having a good time from that joke.
Oh, yeah. Like the
type thing, right?
Yeah, like so. Even before, like before he segued into the joke.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You know how Will Smith, $20 million, something... He can't win over Will Smith. And then shit just went left after the G.I. and Jane joke.
Shit went left like the slap to Chris Rock's face.
Yeah, yo.
But, so I was saying, like, that's why I thought it was fake. Because the Oscars being dead.
Yeah.
There was boycott. What was like, before COVID.
Yeah.
There was no numbers.
Yeah.
Everybody, every, like, good actor goes to the Oscars. They never win.
Yeah.
That's why most of, like, the artists and the actors have been boycotting it and then now they needed a spark
and they have more
people to watch it
and they have more black people winning and appearing at the show this year
with
black producers
exactly
so
but now it's like if it was planned it would be pretty bad because it's making them look bad.
Yes.
Like on national TV.
Exactly, yeah.
Like type thing. But that's what you don't want to do.
Exactly, yeah.
But then, when he started swearing, I'm like, yeah, it could be kind of real. But he still should have went up and said like, yo, I'm sorry for hitting you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But then when he's crying in the speech.
Yeah.
It's like someone puts out like the speech after he wins.
Yeah.
And he goes, oh, he said sorry to Chris. I'm like, no, he didn't.
He didn't apologize during the speech.
He apologized to the Academy. He didn't apologize to. The first words out of his mouth should have said, I'm sorry, Chris. I was out of line.
Yeah.
Like, I know you said that joke.
Had he apologized in that moment, it would have been
That's what I'm
better.
Saying. It would have been, like, all good.
Yeah.
Because, like, P. Diddy's like, oh, yeah, we're going to go back in the party. And
oh, Diddy trying to be the peacemaker. We got to move on with love when you're the one that freaking smacked Drake over a song that he, a beat that he stole from you.
Exactly. So then that happened.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, like, how can you not say sorry? You're at the fucking Oscars, bro.
Yeah.
But I have to give it to Chris Rock. He handled it like a man.
Trust
me,
dog.
He didn't hit him back.
Yeah.
He just moved on. People were calling him a pussy and shit. I'm like,
how
is
he a pussy? A pussy, I mean. I said,
how's he a pussy? How's he a pussy?
How is he a pussy? Like, dog.
How's he a pussy?
None
fam?
Of y'all would have been able to take a slap like that and keep going. Like, y'all probably would have been crying or whatever, you know?
Crying, fam? You paid crumb crying.
Like, dog, like, he has a job to do. He's on live television. You have to prepare for anything. He did what he's supposed to do as a man and as a comedian and as a host.
No,
but he's a pussy. Y'all just dumb for saying that.
No, that, and he's on the biggest stage in the world. He did, like, why would you freaking just start a fight? It'll make him even look even more worse than what you're
exactly
like, what
bro.
Happened.
Yeah, yo, it'll
so
fuck up
no
the whole show. Exactly. People who say that are just stupid as fuck.
And then later that day, when like I don't know if it was Tuesday or Wednesday when Will Smith put out the public apology.
Yeah, like a day or two later.
Through
Instagram, yeah.
Yeah, through Instagram, which I also thought it was not really by him.
Yeah.
People are saying it's by his lawyers and stuff like
that. Yeah, or his pub, his
or
team.
Publicist. Yeah, yeah. So then on top of that, they were also asked, like, Chris Rock's brother.
Yeah.
Chris Rock's brother is like, no, I'm not good with that apology.
Yeah.
Because if you want to say sorry to him, call him.
Yeah. Talk to him directly.
Or at least, you have your publicist write your apology letter.
Yeah, or make a public apology. Yeah. Say it with your voice.
Yourself.
Don't just type it.
Or you know what you do? You know how Will Smith, like, goes to, like, other artists, like, on his YouTube channel or whatever?
Yeah.
Just call him over Zoom.
Yeah.
And just speak over it and tell him you're sorry.
Exactly.
That's it.
Yeah, yo. And plus, the funny thing is, like, yo, Chris Rock protected Will Smith even more because I heard that the LAPD was going to arrest him
right
then
and
there.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, they came up to Chris and they gave him options, you know, sue him or file
a
police report. And Chris was like, no, I don't want any of that. I'm fine, I'm fine.
Yeah, yeah.
And one of the producers came up to him backstage after the slap, asking him, like, yo, you good? And he's like, yeah, I got slapped by Muhammad Ali.
And then there was another meme, too. Like, after he hit Chris Rock.
Yeah.
They're like, this is why his mama sent him out to Philly.
Yeah. Like, yo, Philly came out of him
exactly that
time. Yo, that was the Fresh Prince, like what you see in the new one. And, yo, I was going to tell you, like, where I was when I saw this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yo, like, I just came home late that Sunday.
You said, you just came in.
Yeah, from doing Uber.
And your brothers were watching the
Oscars,
right?
Yeah, my brother was downstairs watching it. It was on the TV. Live. And I saw it on
live
TV.
Live and in the cut.
Yeah, yo. And I saw it. I'm like, oh, the Oscars is on? Okay. I'm just fixing myself some food to eat.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I missed the slap, right? But then I think my brother, he saw the slap, but I missed it.
Yeah.
I noticed that, you know, I hear Chris Rock speaking and all of a sudden I hear
like he was all muted, right?
Yeah, I saw the audio muted. I'm like, wait, what's going on? And I hear my brother react. I'm like, yo, I turn around, see the TV. The camera's cut to Will Smith, audio muted, and him yelling. I'm like, yo, what's going on? What's he angry about?
Yeah.
And then...
Oh, then your brother told you what happened?
Yeah, like after the fact. And then I see Chris Rock with saying the part where Chris Rock saying like, okay, that's the greatest night in television. I'm like, yo, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, yeah.
He made a joke that he didn't like or whatever. I'm like, oh shit, something went on. So
exactly.
I immediately message you guys and then I go to Twitter. So I'm like, yo, what's going on?
But it was weird because
it
came out like, as, like, usually when something happens on live TV, it doesn't go out like that.
Oh, the internet is way too fast.
It's way too fast. Like,
to
me, if it came out like that fast,
yeah,
like, something had to be planned to, like, try to provoke like Will Smith to do something, because you can't really put something out that fast. I don't think so.
Nah, the internet's just fast.
No, it is, like, it is fast.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, like, as soon as you he slapped him,
yeah,
boom, like, not even, bro, not even 1 second later, whole Instagram was that. The Japanese version was out.
Yeah.
Him swear. Bro, how do you get this that fast?
It's the internet. Shit just travels fast on
bro,
the internet.
Bro, that's fucking fast.
I know,
bro.
Man. Like, just like that. Of course, and it's Will Smith, one of the biggest names in the world. Shit like that, yo, it's going to pop off immediately.
I wish I can get my packages delivered that fucking fast.
For real,
like,
bro.
Fuck, bro.
Yeah, yo. Like,
Amazon ain't even that fast.
Yeah, like, bro, like, information media just travels so fast these days through
bro,
the internet.
Like, as soon as he slapped him. Like that, boom, out already on the internet.
Viral moment, viral.
I'm like, bro. Jeez, man.
Yeah,
jeez,
yo. Louise. And of course, you see, Chris Rock's social media numbers go up. Like the post promoting his new tour with Kevin Hart, 200,000 likes after the slap.
That and he also
and the
has,
ticket sales are going up. So this is helping
that
him.
That and his ticket sales. It's kind of funny when his tour dates are all in August as well, too. That's like, but I'm pretty sure those were already out anyways.
Yeah.
But it's more funnier now after what happened.
Definitely, bro. And he's like, going to talk about it. He's going to talk about it.
He had a show. I don't know if it was Tuesday or Wednesday.
Yeah.
He came out on stage, but he said like his whole show was already written from last week.
Yeah.
He says right now I'm still processing what happened.
Yeah.
I'm not going to talk about it in this show.
Yeah. Stay
he
tuned,
said,
y'all.
Later down.
Yeah.
Like when we can all laugh about it.
Yeah.
And then that's when he'll, but like, he says, as of right now, he says, I don't know what the fuck's going on.
Yeah.
I have my other content to like friggin', to let out. So,
yeah. Now he's the hottest comedian in the game.
Yo, but when, so the one that he's doing with Kevin Hart.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Rock Hart.
Yeah.
It's almost like, so is that going to be like a Netflix special or they're just doing tours with each other?
Maybe it's I haven't really heard about that.
It'd be
that.
Pretty cool though if it was like a Netflix special.
Yeah, yeah, of the tour. Of
yeah,
them
of the tour. Yeah.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah, like just showing each stand up through Netflix.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, which would bring in some more though.
Yep.
So yeah,
well,
yo.
Maybe that will come out in August too.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. So yeah, like of course, like I know, Will Smith was wrong for the slap. I feel like he should have at least. Yep. It would have been better if he just went up. And
no,
just,
not even that. If he was just yelling at him,
yeah,
fine.
Just, that one was okay. But yeah. If he's gonna
get
up,
to get up and fucking slap the man.
But if he's gonna get up and go
like,
on stage,
put him, like in a little like soft little headlock, like yo, bro.
Yeah, yeah, like playing around with him or whatever.
Like, yo, man, can you stop talking about my wife like that type thing?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
He'd be like, okay, cool.
Yeah,
but you don't need to slap the man, damn.
Exactly, bro. And
leave
I know
the Philly side. At home.
Yeah, yo. And plus, like, at the end of his apology, I'm a work in progress. Damn, like, even at age 53, you're a work in progress. Not to slap
like,
somebody in,
then,
on live stage at an award show.
And then a couple days later, they had his mom come out of, his mom was, like, saying, Will's never acted like this in his life.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, this man's been through a lot.
Yeah, I was going to say.
He was at the round table, and then she fully told him.
Red table talk, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, you know what table.
Yeah.
Talk.
Yeah.
And then she fully told him, me and August, we had an entanglement.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro.
Yeah.
The dude's like your son's age.
Yeah. Crazy.
I'm like, nah, bro, that doesn't slide. Like,
oh,
I
wait, as Jaden? No, he's older than Jaden. August. Yeah, Jaden ain't that old.
Is it his friend or the other son's friend?
Because
they have an other son.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about the firstborn.
Yeah, but
yeah,
from Will's other.
Before
right?
he married Jada.
So is it
Jada.
August the first son's friend or Jaden?
Yeah,
friend?
Trey Smith. Yeah.
Is it
same age as his oldest son?
I'm pretty sure.
Yes, you're right. You're right.
So what does his oldest son do?
Trey.
Though?
Oh, like I heard
is
he's
he
like
in a,
he DJs and whatever.
Oh, so he doesn't.
He doesn't really
like acting.
No.
Rap and stuff like that.
No, he's not really in the spot like Jaden and Willow.
Because when they took photos at the Oscars, I'm like I knew they had an old, like I knew he had an older son.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I don't know if is August like Trey.
Yeah.
Like
both,
age or.
Yeah. Around that. They're both the
yeah,
same.
Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. I'm like.
Crazy.
Yo, bro. I didn't. I'm like, nah. Like,
yeah.
Obviously he's still hurt from that. 100%.
Yeah.
But then bro, like from a little joke.
Yeah.
Like, you go punch Chris Rock, but you don't punch the man that fucking slept with your wife?
Yeah, yo.
Bro, like, you need to go punch the man that slept with your wife, my
Instead
guy.
Of saying, keep my wife's name out your mouth, how about keep my wife's pussy out your mouth? How about that?
Or keep your fucking dick out my wife's pussy.
And like, yo, in that situation where Chris Rock is making a joke about Jada, you know what I would have done in that situation? Me, what I would do? Nothing, because I would have divorced that from time.
Exactly.
We wouldn't. I wouldn't.
Because after the table, talk.
They actually did it based on that, right?
No, they did. They like that's when like the memes came out of Will Smith crying at the
table. Oh, for the entanglement. Yeah, but I heard they're gonna
do another one.
Yeah, for this. Of course they are. Yeah.
But they're even more stupid because why would you only do it with just you two? You should bring Chris Rock on the table as well too.
Yeah.
And be like, "I'm Chris Rock. Yo, what the fuck happened?
Yeah.
Like I said a joke. Okay. You fucked August. Why didn't you punch that man? I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
You should be punching that guy, not fucking Chris Rock for saying a fucking little joke.
Yeah.
Like I understand, yeah, like she has like the hair loss like disease or whatever.
Yeah.
But like the dude fucked your wife, bro.
Yeah. But then again, I'm pretty sure he approved it because of that open marriage agreement they have.
Okay, but still, what I didn't like at the end of the thing, they're like, bad marriage for life. I'm like, bro, no.
Nah.
No such thing as for life.
The fact that they used to be couple goals.
I'm like, no, bro.
Nah,
and then there was another one, too. There was another meme that said if Tupac was alive, he would have shot Chris Rock.
Yeah, I saw that one. That's funny as hell, man. Absolutely funny.
Will, man, you soft.
Yeah, I know. Like, I feel like it's just a buildup of all the bullshit he's been going through.
It is, but you can't take it over a little joke like that, bro.
Yeah. Like, yeah, Chris Rock, like, yo, come on, that was a funny one. I mean, that was a funny one, you know?
But Will Smith was laughing, so it was a funny one.
Yeah, I mean, it's okay if he took offense to it, but he just should have handled it more better instead of just slapping him.
Yeah.
You know?
Like I said, he should have just went up, put him in a little, like, friggin' pretend, like, friendly headlock.
Yeah.
Yo, man, can you cut those jokes out?
Yeah.
Okay, bro.
Yeah.
Go sit back down.
Yeah, exactly, you know?
And then, you can yell at him after if he says it again.
Yeah.
Come on, dude. It's a G.I. Jane joke. Come on, dude.
Yeah. Not an alopecia joke. You know? So, yeah. And plus, you know, the funny thing is, this was so big. They're even talking about this shit on the sports networks.
Yeah.
Yeah, like they're talking about it Shannon on First Sharp, Take and Undisputed.
Shannon Sharp said, if Will Smith did that to me, you're getting your ass beat.
And you hear Skip Bayless talking about this shit like it was a boxing fight. Yo, Chris Rock, he leaned in. He took the shot. He leaned in.
He took it for his family. He took it. He took it. And then like Skip Bayless, he also said this. Shannon Sharp. Like, if I say something wrong, don't hit me, bro.
Don't hit me. Don't go Will Smith on me.
And I was dying.
And what's it called? You hear Stephen A. Smith on Instagram. What Will Smith did was straight bullshit. Come on. Black producer, black man in front of white people. Come on, man.
But in the beginning, he was on Will Smith's side. And then after that, I'm like, Rio, why are you switching sides?
Yeah, he always switches sides.
I'm like, bro.
He doesn't stay consistent.
I'm like, relax, Stephen A. Smith. Stick to sports, my guy.
But yo, imagine if Stephen A. Smith were the one saying that joke, and then he sees Will Smith coming up to him. He'd be like, whoa, wait, stop right there. You know what? I'm sorry, Will.
I'm sorry.
And before he comes up, I'd be like, hey. What you gonna do? It's just a joke. What you gonna do?
He's gonna like throw out some big ass word in front of you.
And you see the meme with Kevin Hart. You're gonna slap me, bitch. In front of my fans. Chris Rock backstage after getting slapped.
Yep.
You're gonna slap me, bitch.
Ooh, he slapped me. Woo.
All the memes are just absolutely funny, man.
It made my week, but every talk show, bro, all week long, bro.
Yeah.
Just let it die for a bit.
Nah, this ain't ever gonna die.
No, but I'm saying
this is forever.
On some of the talk shows, you talked about it Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
Yeah.
Why are you still talking about the same incident? Like nothing changed. He didn't actually say sorry.
Yeah.
Like his publishers did.
Yeah. Well, like, because more details are coming out now. That's why they keep talking about it.
What's the more details that?
Oh, yeah, about like, you know, the LAPD nearly arresting him.
Yeah, but that was like after the Oscars, they said.
Yeah.
Chris Rock didn't want to charge him.
Yeah.
So then leave it at that.
Yeah. But like the first day, people were talking about like, yo, is this real or fake? Oh, this got to be fake. This can't be real. But now we know for a fact after these details, this shit was real. It just seemed fake, by the way.
Jim Carrey came out saying
he should have sued him. That's what he said.
Yeah, Because also Jim Carrey said, oh, if that happened to me, I would have sued him for $200 million.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, you're just saying that because you probably just want more money.
Yeah. And I guess this just goes to show that if the host were white, then Will Smith would have been sued or arrested. You know? Yeah, that's what they're saying.
But still, like, I understand, like, Jim Carrey was saying he shouldn't have deserved, like, the standing ovation.
Yeah.
But, like, after what he did.
Yeah.
Because it's like, he shouldn't have.
Yeah.
But he did put a lot of work into that movie.
Exactly.
And, like, all of his other roles.
Yeah.
You can't just take away one bad moment and then take it away.
Exactly,
for, like, everything he did in his whole life.
Yeah, for King Richard, which I should watch, by the way.
Yeah, I heard it was, like, really good.
Yeah, based on the Venus and Serena growing up, you know?
Because I remember I brought it up in the earlier pod that it was coming out.
Yeah.
But I just didn't know when it was coming out.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, I heard it was, like, really good.
Yeah, even before the Oscars, I was interested in watching it because, like, it's Will Smith.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, it's a good story that
And he always goes, like, deep in those roles when he's playing somebody else.
Yeah, exactly.
When he's playing himself, it's okay.
Yeah.
But when he plays, like, somebody else. Oh,
he does well. Yeah. Yep. I didn't even see Ali yet. I heard he really killed that role.
I don't remember seeing that one either.
Yeah, I haven't seen that. That was like early 2000s, you know?
Like, maybe seen the trailer.
But I've seen, like, scenes here and there, like compilations. Yeah. But yeah, I'm going to see that when I get the chance. So it's I know, like, now it's like, because I know, like, for us growing up, we've known Will Smith for, like, you know, the music, his rap career, and the movies that he's been in and whatever. But of course, like, these days, these kids growing up, they're just going to know Will Smith for, like, the slap at the Oscars, you know? Because, like, they ain't growing up on Will Smith like how we did. You know, they don't know who these, like, legends are.
Like, my boy right here.
Man got the Fresh Prince DVDs and shit, you know? Like, that night he was the Fresh Prince straight out of Philly.
Straight out of Philly, my guy.
You know, he was reliving the Fresh Prince days at that Oscars. You know, so, yeah, man. And plus, but I feel like, Will Smith resigned from the Academy.
Yeah, but for him resigning, what does that mean? Like, he's just never his going
membership.
Back?
Like, he's no longer a member of the
Academy. Oh, okay.
That's all.
He still gets to keep the Oscar.
Yeah, keep the Oscar, you know? Okay. Just like with Kawhi leaving the Raptors. Yeah, he's no longer part of the team, but after the championship, he still keeps the ring.
No, he doesn't. Yo, did Danny Green even get his ring yet?
I'm pretty sure he didn't.
There's fans. We have fans now.
Yeah, so it's time to get it already.
If you don't want it, buddy, I'm going to take it from you. Just throwing that out there.
Yeah.
Because that ring is hella nice.
Also, before we get off this Will Smith, Chris Rock thing, what would you have done in that situation?
I would basically do the same thing what Chris Rock done.
Or just...
Let him.
Just let it go?
Because you're on the biggest stage, bro. Because, like, you're there, like... Because you're celebrating everything else.
Yeah.
Why would you want to ruin that moment with another bad moment?
Exactly. Yeah.
You're on the biggest stage. You're going to make yourself look even more, like, bad.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. To me, what Chris Rock did, I would have done the same thing.
Yeah.
Maybe you would have done something different.
Oh, like me, Chris Rock?
No.
If
you were in the moment, would you have hit Will Smith back?
Me? Hell no.
If it wasn't the Oscars, then maybe.
Yes.
Maybe the Source Awards, the Music Awards. Or something like that, right?
Yeah, yo.
But not the Oscars. No, you can't do that at the Oscars.
Yeah, yo. My reaction just would have been different. Instead of saying, "Oh wow," I'd be like, "What the fuck?"
Yeah, like, what the fuck? And then I would have said that August joke.
Yeah.
That's what I would have said. Then we would have might have a problem, but I still would have if he hit me again.
Yeah.
Oh damn! Two times in one night. Damn. Not as much time as August.
But if you were Chris Buck, but what about if you were Will Smith? You would just sit in your seat, not do nothing about
it? If I was Will Smith?
Yeah.
No, bro, like...
After hearing that joke.
After hearing it, I would have basically, like, what I told you. I would have went up, gave him a little, like, friendly headlock.
Yeah, like you said.
Yeah, like I said.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need to punch the man. You're on fucking national TV, bro.
Yeah, violence. Or at least
talk to him after the show.
Yeah.
Like, the joke's out there.
Yeah.
But you should know that those jokes... are not written by him.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like, I know, I'm pretty sure he goes over the jokes before saying it.
Yeah.
And he probably thought, oh, yeah, like, they're close to me.
Yeah.
Like, I'm close to them. Maybe they'll laugh at the joke. Maybe I'll try it out.
Yeah, they, like, you know, they've been buddies,
you
know?
That's what I'm saying.
So, yeah, from time. Me, personally, like, of course, me, I'm never the type to act out in public.
Yeah.
You know, so I would do everything but slap him or curse him. I'd probably, you know, signal out saying like, yo, cut them jokes out. Like, I'll say signal out like, yo, cut it out.
Cut the tape.
You know?
Cut the tape.
Or if I'm going to walk up and stage and approach him, I definitely won't hit him.
No, yeah.
You know, I'd be like, hey, don't make them jokes. She has alopecia. I'm not sure if you're aware of this, you know?
Yep.
Like, I always try to handle things, you know, and fix
there's
situations.
No need of slapping the man on national TV.
Yeah, exactly. You know, so, yeah. And like, you saw, like, footage of him at an after party, like, after the Oscars, of him celebrating and partying.
Yep, and then Jaden, I don't know if you've seen his...
Yeah,
his
that's tweet. How we do.
That's how we do.
Yeah.
You fuck up the Oscars and win an Oscar. That's how we do, fam.
Yeah, and plus the funny thing is, it's like, yo, it's as if nothing happened.
Yeah, he's, exactly.
Yeah, with his song playing in the background, that Miami song.
Yeah, the
Miami
song.
And there's a one line with the lady saying, Will, we loved your last hit. Yeah, now that
is your last hit.
Yeah, that's your last hit, you know? Is that the hit that they're referring to? Not the song, like your hit against Chris Rock.
Now that Joyner Lucas song that he did with Will Smith.
Yeah, he tweeted, I'm feeling like Will. Yeah, slapping somebody for making fun of my wife.
He needs to add that to the
Will remix.
The after slap remix.
Yeah, yo. It's like, no, y'all got to remix that again.
And then
again.
It was Redman's song, too. Slap the shit out.
Oh, yeah. Smack the shit out you.
Smack the shit out
you. Yo, that's what I was thinking. Like, yo, enough rappers are going to be making bars about this shit.
They already did. But I'm like, bro, like, you can only be, like, clever, like, maybe a couple times. And everything's just going to be recycled.
Yeah.
Like, it's stupid. But, like, the best one for me will be, like, Redman, smack the shit out you.
Yeah.
Like, that one actually goes to smack the shit out you.
Yeah. Oh, no, but this is before. I'm talking, like,
after this moment.
After this moment.
But now listening to that song is like...
Oh, yeah. Like, songs that, you know,
yeah,
may age gracefully in conjunction
smack
to that.
Smack the will out you.
Yeah.
Smack the will out you.
A slap could make Chris Rock at Will or something that. I saw that meme of Drake if we were to write that shit. Yeah.
Yeah, or something like that.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Like, Drake's writing on, like... He's, what was it, the Take Care album or something like that?
Yeah.
He's like sitting at the table.
Yeah. Of course, yeah, we're going to be hearing this in music,
or slapping
bro.
You at your will or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, exactly.
Rock hard slap at your will.
Yeah. Get rocked like Chris.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. But of course, but I feel like, you know, Chris Rock is fine, you know? He's fine.
Yeah.
This is going to help his tour do numbers, and plus,
yeah,
because
like, even Adam Sandler congratulated him on his numbers as well too.
Yeah, exactly.
He goes, good
you know?
Job, buddy. Love you.
Yeah, and plus Will Smith, he still got the Oscar. He's not
exactly.
getting sued.
Yep.
You know, Chris got him. He ain't gonna sue him.
Yep.
He ain't gonna press charges. He's fine. He still has a career after this. He still got millions of dollars. So this doesn't. This
and Bel Air season 2 is coming out.
Let's go, bro.
Let's go.
Yeah, I need to catch up. I got some time to finish the episode now that the season's done.
But to me, I don't really. Like how there's only 10 episodes.
Yeah, per season, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro.
I mean, it's good. Gives me time because I'm a few episodes behind.
But just put them out at all fucking one time, bro.
Yeah.
I don't mind. I don't know. To me,
I don't mind waiting. I'm a patient guy.
Sometimes.
No, most. I'm very patient.
But like to me, when a show like that good comes out.
Yeah.
I want to watch all.
Yeah, you want to watch
I
want
to watch it all. Like all.
Yeah, right away. Like, just go every week. But me, I like the anticipation. I just love the anticipation.
And then when I posted it on like the Bel Air page, oh, you ruined it for me. So why are you still in the page when everybody else is talking about it? Same with Topo. Oh, no, you guys ruined it for me. Bro, it's all fans want to talk about what happened in the season.
Yes.
So if you don't want to hear it, get the fuck out the group for now. Or put the notifications on silent.
Yeah.
Well, most of them did. And then when you watch the season, come back.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, relax. You're gonna watch the same episode we did.
Yeah.
So what's the difference?
Yeah, yo. And also, yeah, not also that it's April. Yeah, it's Grammy month this month. But I don't give a shit anyways. I'm not
Is
watching
Chris
the Grammys.
Chris Rock and Will Smith going to be there?
Kanye ain't going to be there, but I don't give a shit.
Kanye.
Yeah, but anyways, because it got delayed because of COVID, but who cares? I'm not watching no Grammys.
Nah.
I'd rather watch.
Isn't the Grammys this Sunday?
I believe Sunday, but still I'm not watching that.
I'm going to laugh something else happens or someone tries to like imitate
it. Nah, yo, fuck that. Nah.
No, but I mean like, I'm pretty sure they're going to try to.
Oh, yeah. There's going to be like skits. Yeah, bet they'll probably do that shit on Saturday Night Live.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. 100%.
But yeah, but I've been over the gram. He's not watching that shit no more.
Yes, sir.
I'd rather watch Hitomi Tanaka's last porno vid.
Wow. Anyways.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What's it called? Yeah, she's retiring. For those who don't know, yeah, famous Japanese porn star from, yeah, who got big titties.
Big titties, fam. Yeah. She got the big titties, fam.
When I found out she's retiring, my heart dropped. It's like, bro, melons, fam. Who am I going to jerk off to next?
Wow. Anyways.
Yeah, yo. Anyway,
I don't think our mics are working right now.
Yeah. Oh, is it going to cut me out just because I'm talking about porn stars? Yeah. I'm just saying, like, bro, I'd rather watch Hitomi Tanaka's last porno movie instead of the Grammys. That's how much I'd rather not watch the Grammys.
This is the podcast about the Grammys. The Grammys only. And the Oscars.
Yeah.
This is the Oscar podcast. The Oscar-worthy podcast.
Yeah. Who's still going to watch the Grammys after this? I mean, the Oscars after this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What else?
In what else?
Okay, yeah. Well, I'll get to the funny bars of the week afterwards. But we're going to talk about sports. Raptors on a roll. Six seed.
After. But when do they secure the six seed? Do they still have to win other games to secure the six seed? Because aren't they tied with the Bulls right now?
Oh, no. I think they're half a game behind the Bulls.
Oh, half a game.
Yeah, either half a game or a full game behind the Bulls for fifth place. They're just
Down like we're still down a couple games because they canceled some of our games due to COVID.
April. So that's an April Fool's joke, right? Or is it for real?
No, this is for real.
Oh, okay.
There was, I think, a game against the Knicks they canceled.
Yeah.
And another game. The third game, they let us play for some reason. When we had like six or seven guys.
Yeah.
And the NBA said, fuck it. And we lost that game by like 30 or 40 points.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, the games that we missed due to like both teams being infected by COVID.
Yeah.
Do we get those games back?
Yeah, we're supposed to get those games back.
Really?
Yeah, exactly. It's part of the schedule.
No, it is. Yeah. But I don't see those games at the end of the season.
Oh, really?
On the thing. So are they going to shorten our season?
No, they can't.
They shouldn't, right?
That wouldn't be fair. No.
Yep.
You'd have to, like,
because I don't think we're going to get 82 games.
No, yeah, that we'd have
like
to get
we have out. To, right?
Yeah, exactly. Because otherwise, that's not going to make the thing fair. That's, like, interfering.
No, that's what I'm saying. Because I don't see the schedule for, like, for those games yet, or unless they're out already. But last time I checked during the week, I didn't see it.
Yeah.
So who knows?
Yeah, we'll see. But at least we're in sixth place right now.
Yep.
So, you know, we're trying to stay off that seven seed.
So, yep.
Yeah. And
as long as we get fifth, sixth, I'm happy.
Yeah, exactly. Around that time. Around those seedings.
Then I also heard something about if any teams face us, whoever's not vaccinated can't play.
Yeah.
I seen a post like that.
Oh, too. Yeah. Any unvaccinated players, they just can't cross the border for now. You know, so... Yeah.
Or I seen something on CP24 too.
Yeah.
That they're not going by the border thing anymore. I don't know if that's only driving or if that's for planes.
Oh, yeah.
It came out on CP24 today.
Oh, like the vaccine protocol.
You don't have to get tested or...
Oh, yeah, you no longer have to get tested, right?
Yeah, like at
as long as you're
testing.
Vaccinated, right?
I never read that part. Maybe that's what it's going to be.
Yeah, maybe but that's just for like vaccinated people.
They said like there's no more testing at the border, so
yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
It would be nice if it went both ways.
Exactly. Like
if you don't need a test, just go over.
Yeah, no test, but you still have to be vaccinated across the border, which is bullshit. So, anyways,
You had LeBron James tweet today that he was out for the rest of the season.
Yeah, with nice April Fool's joke.
Yes.
So, if the Raptors were to play, we beat the Orlando Magic tonight.
Yes.
And Kyle Lowry's return is on Sunday.
On Sunday.
Yeah, so that's 7 o'clock. I'm going to be watching that.
I'll be watching some of it at work. Hopefully, I have a computer close by.
Yeah, I'm going to do a few hours of Uber and then come back home and watch it.
No, you're going to be doing Uber for the
whole
time.
Oh, no, I'm not gonna miss the game for Uber. No, I'm not. Mm-hmm. But what's it called? If the playoffs were to start today, we'd be facing Celtics, who are the third seed. Who
really?
We just beat earlier this week in overtime.
Yeah.
Guy, no, Jalen Brown and Jason Tatum wasn't playing.
We won by?
By three, in overtime. Yeah. Yeah. I know JT and JB weren't playing, but, a win's a win.
A win's a win, my guy.
Siakam went off, He's been having a good month.
Siakam's been good ever since All-Star break.
Yeah, yo, like.
It's like, you didn't select me as All-Star?
Yeah.
I'm going to turn it on right now.
Oh, yeah, for real, yeah. Man. For real. Exactly. That's all I was trying to tell people.
I know, I've been trying to hate, but, like, the first half of the season, he wasn't this good.
Yeah.
So, he's been showing up.
Right yeah, now. He has been. He has been. Yeah, yeah. Because, like, I was saying, like, yo, just give Siakam a chance to play a full season with the Raptors back in Toronto. Because before COVID, the bubble.
The Tampa Bay season,
he wasn't really.
I seen someone wear the Tampa Bay. Remember the jersey that they made, the pink and like blue one?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was one guy in the fans like tonight wearing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I was like, oh, okay. I didn't know like this. Like I know there's websites selling it. I didn't know like they were still selling it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like it would still be pretty sick to have.
Yeah.
Like a Raptors jersey like that.
Oh, for real? Yep. Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Yeah, man. But okay, so for a first round series against Boston, if that were to happen.
But I also heard like we can also end up facing Miami too.
Yeah.
If like I'm not saying 100%, but there's like a chance of us facing Miami as well.
Who are the second seed, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. If we fall to seventh and
we win
our first play in game.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But like,
To me, I would rather watch Miami versus Toronto.
Yeah, with Kyle Lowry.
Yep.
Complete playing against us.
Because the Boston, I'm like, yeah, cool. We face him in the bubble. It was whatever. Yeah. Marcus Smart's going to do his dumb shit again.
Yeah.
His Marcus dumb shit.
But I'd rather we face Boston in the playoffs for the first round.
Yeah.
Because remember, what's it called? Like, the first game against them in the season when we beat their ass.
Yeah.
By like 30 plus points on the road, but Scottie Barnes had a big game that game, 25 and 13.
But you have to think about playoffs as different type of basketball compared to regular season.
Yeah, yeah, I know that.
So we're not gonna beat them by 30.
Yeah, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying because like, yo, we're 2-2 against them. So we can. I'm not saying like, oh, we'll beat them, but I would rather them over Miami.
Six or seven games, regardless, anyway.
Yeah, like that would be an easier opponent for the first round than Miami.
No, yeah. But it would be nice to see that, though.
Yeah, and plus, like, we're playing with house money. There was no expectations for us this season.
No, exactly, yeah.
You know, so, you know, like, we're not expected to advance to the second round, which is okay, you know? Yeah. I just play your hardest, be competitive, and we live with the results,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, because right now, as long as we're above Cavs, we're good.
Yeah, exactly, you know? Like, I'm just, like, you know, nobody had expectations for us to make playoffs, and we're already overachieving, you know? So, which is good enough for me.
Yep.
Because, you know,
as long as we're there.
Yeah, because, like, you know.
As long as the Lakers stay out of playoffs. You know?
Yeah. We ain't worried about them. They in the West.
No, man. I know. I know. Because I know they ain't going to go far anyways.
So. Yeah, exactly. They
likely probably lose the play-in anyways.
They likely might not make the play-in.
That, I also heard, I don't know if this is true or not.
Yeah.
If the Lakers obviously don't make playoffs in off-season.
Yeah.
I heard Carmelo has been giving out hints that he wants to go back to Denver.
Oh, I thought you were going to say he plans to retire.
No.
Okay.
Or unless he wants to go to Denver, then retire.
Well, that would be nice if he were to go.
Yeah, because if he plays with them now, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Denver now.
Yeah.
Like, I know, like, he's not the same anymore.
Yeah.
But he could still, like, come off the bench and, like, give you some nice minutes.
Yeah, he could definitely can still contribute.
That's what I'm saying.
You know, to a second unit. So.
Like that would be nice. And then if he just retires over there, bro, he said.
Yeah.
Like, he shouldn't retire as the Laker. You need to retire, go back to Denver where you started.
Yeah, yo.
And then that's it.
Yeah, exactly. To a team that's actually competing, you know?
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't go over there before the Lakers.
Well, he didn't get the opportunity to.
Well, I'm hoping he can, like.
He went to the Lakers just because LeBron was recruiting him. Oh, it's time. Let's get this ring.
It's time, yeah, but it's not time, my guy.
Yeah, oh, no, yeah, ring my.
It's a little too late,
but. Ring my neck back. Y'all in the play-in. Y'all playing for play-in.
They're playing for playing.
Exactly.
You guys are playing for playing.
Playing for nothing.
You don't get a ring for playing.
Yeah. So, yeah, and plus, like, yeah, like, Denver's actually been competing. Yep. Like, Jamal Murray, like,
he's coming back for playoffs, right?
Oh, is he?
He should be okay?
I heard
he's supposed to be, I don't know about 100%.
Yeah.
But I heard he might be coming back for playoffs.
Oh, okay, because it's been, like, I think a year since his ACL injury.
Yeah, basically from last year playoffs.
Yeah, right? Yeah, yeah. Oh, no, this was, like, before the playoffs. Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was during.
Yeah, it happened in the season before last year's playoffs.
Yes.
So that'll be nice. I think, yeah, Denver's definitely in the mix. Jokic has been holding it down. So, yeah, definitely, like.
He's been nice, my guy.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see Melo back with Denver next season. You know, if that, like, don't re-sign to the Lakers.
Like, I know it's probably just, like, a rumor, but I hope it's a true rumor.
Yeah.
And like, yo, make it happen, my guy.
And I'm pretty sure I see Melo. He got at least 1 year left in him.
Yeah. Just don't retire right now, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 1 year left and then retire.
Yeah, or like one and a half type thing.
But like make another run for it, like, and compete.
Yeah, exactly. Just don't sign to another team just for the money.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Or like, sign just because LeBron told you to come. That's what I'm saying. You know?
Because I think, what, Melo only signed for 1 year, right?
Yeah, yeah, like, 1 year.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, ever since, like, you know, when he joined Portland, it's just been 1 year deals.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so. Yeah, yeah. And,
but he's been playing nice since he got picked up by Portland, so.
Yeah, yeah, definitely, yep. You know? So. Yeah, yo. And also, what else in sports? Yo, Giannis, he passed Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yes, so now he's the number one scorer on the Bucks all time.
Yeah, most points ever in Bucks franchise history after that monster game against Brooklyn. 44 points, 14 rebounds.
And then for that three to end the game. Well, not really end the game, but there was only a couple seconds left.
Yeah.
To give them that dagger, you know?
Oh, no. He ended the game with free throws.
Free
throws? Yeah.
No, but that three put him in the lead.
Oh, no, it tied it to go into overtime, yeah.
Oh,
to
overtime, yeah. Three-toe.
Yeah, the step back three after the crossover nails it.
Oh, that was...
Yeah, that was to tie the game and send it into overtime. Yes, yeah, yeah.
I'm watching the video, I'm like... I didn't see them go like crazy to win.
Yeah, that was in regulation to tie the game. Because
they just showed it. And then that was it. I'm like, what the fuck's going on?
Yeah, yeah. Like,
I thought it was like he did that in overtime type
thing. Oh, no,
no. Just regular type.
Yeah, what he did in overtime was make two clutch free throws.
Oh, I'm surprised.
Yeah, exactly. And just this season.
Freaking Drake wasn't there?
Drake? Nah. Why would he be at a Brooklyn-Milwaukee game?
He's Durant's boy, my guy.
He's more so LeBron's boy.
No, I know. But it would have been funny if he was just like laughing at him with the free throws again.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. But yeah, but that would be unless if he was playing us in Toronto.
Yeah.
Yeah, then Drake would be
there. That would have been funny.
He had no business being in Brooklyn.
He could be anywhere, my facing guy.
Milwaukee. Yeah, yeah. Well, at a Heat game. Well, because Kyle Lowry's there.
Yep.
Yeah, he can be anywhere, or for the Lakers. Yeah, basically one of them big market teams.
Yep.
Just one or two of them.
Okay, my guy.
Yeah. But I feel like now Giannis is the best player. This proves that he's the best player. I don't know why they keep calling KD the best player. And I've been saying like, yo, this year the Nets season is a wash.
But KD hasn't been the same since he got injured.
Yeah, exactly. And plus like, yo.
If he was smart, he should have just stayed on Warriors. I don't know why he had to leave.
Maybe. Nah, I support the move to Brooklyn.
Yeah.
It wouldn't make sense for him to stay with Golden State after the argument with him and Draymond.
Yeah, but like now they're like they moved on or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. But like after that, like you're grown men, you shouldn't be holding grudges for that long anyways.
Me? Oh, no, it wasn't a grudge. It's just that, you know, like he came there, won two championships, and he still didn't get the respect he deserved with Steph's team. So it's time for him to do things his way to another team.
Yeah, but you have to take this in. He went to that team knowing it was already Steph's team.
Yeah.
He's not going to go. Like, you're telling me Durant, like, went there saying it's going to be his team? I don't think so.
Oh, but, like, well, not just that. He basically went there just for an easy ring. Now he wants a different challenge. You know?
Two easy rings?
Yeah. Yeah, two easy rings, yeah. I know. I got what you said there. Yeah. Yeah, it's just that things just haven't worked out because last season they could have won it all.
Yep.
Like, you know, he's still... Put himself in a situation to win.
He can't do everything by himself.
Yeah, it's just that James Harden got injured. You know, and Kyrie got injured. He had to try carry the team himself, and he couldn't.
He almost did.
He almost did, but you know,
a few inches too short.
The shot was on his foot was on the line. You know, so
wear smaller shoes, my guy. In the playoffs.
And plus now James Harden is traded. Ben Simmons ain't playing.
But I heard James Harden
and Kyrie couldn't play home games with the vaccine mandate. Yeah.
He's good at play home games now, right?
Yeah, but like this kind of sabotaged their season. So
it did.
You know, so.
Yeah, but they're still in the playoff like contenders.
So. Yeah, yeah. Well, play in. They're basically play in right now.
They're eighth right now?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, exactly. You know, so.
As long as we don't have to face them.
Yeah. Well, no, I don't mind us facing them.
Oh, yeah, because Kyrie can't
play overseas. I mean, over the
border. Or unless they change the rule just for him, which I know that's going to happen.
Yeah, it's not going to happen this season. It's not.
But I'm telling you. I'm going to laugh if it does, just to make Kyrie play watch.
Yeah, but I was just saying, that season is a watch this season. Next season, they're going to be nice.
Yeah.
They're going to be nice with Ben
also. Oh, yeah, because Ben is still, I thought he was supposed to be coming back.
I don't know why he hasn't played yet when he's fully healthy.
Yeah, he's good now, no?
Yeah.
He's been practicing with the team.
Yeah.
So then what the fuck's going on? Is he waiting for playoffs?
I don't know what's the wait.
I don't know.
I don't know what the wait is for, but yeah.
Yep.
But
it's all good.
Yeah, it's all good still, you know. So yeah, but I feel like I was gonna go back to Boston and Toronto, but nah.
We'll we'll see if
yeah,
it
yeah,
happens.
I was just saying, we'll like, see. Yeah, like, we'll I'd rather see. Face them in the first round than Miami.
No,
but
no, yeah, yeah.
That'll be an
more
interesting
like more
first
of a challenge.
Round series.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Like, okay, what else? What else happened in sports? Oh, yeah, can't forget this. Canada qualifies for the World
yes,
Cup.
Yes, Canada.
First time since 1986 after beating Jamaica 4-0 to blow Zenskirt.
And take this in.
Yeah.
The winners of Euro Cup got yeah. eliminated.
Yeah, I heard Italy.
It was very bad.
They got eliminated by who again?
I don't know what the team was, but they weren't that good. It was the 93rd. It was extra time.
Yeah.
93rd minute.
Yeah.
Italy wasn't even playing defense, and the other team just runs in and scores. And Italy just had to tie, I think, that game.
Yeah.
If it was 0-0, just to get in. But
and,
no.
And they couldn't do it.
No. They're going to be sitting out. This is their second World Cup.
Yeah.
In a row.
Yeah.
That they're missing.
That they're missing, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, yo.
But Canada looks like they have a hard division.
Yeah, yo. And we're talking about the men's team because it's usually the woman that makes it into the World Cup for us. But the men's team is definitely gotten better.
Did you see the groups?
No, I haven't seen them, no.
So they have Group A.
Yeah.
Qatar. If you...
Yeah, oh yeah, this year's World Cup is
A?
In Qatar, yeah.
Yeah, so it's been hosted, so obviously the host gets in.
Yeah.
So they're in Group A with Ecuador, Senegal, and Netherlands.
Yeah.
Group B, England, Iran.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Ireland, yeah.
No, Iran.
Iran. Oh, yeah.
The USA, and I think there's another team that still needs to qualify for Group B.
Okay.
So Group C, Argentina, Saudi Arabia, Mexico, and Poland. That's Group C.
Yeah.
Group D is France, Denmark. I don't know. How do you say?
Tunisia.
Yeah,
Tunisia. Yeah, yeah. African
Tunisia?
Country. Yeah.
And then they're also waiting for another team to qualify.
Okay.
In that group.
Okay.
And then Group E, Spain, Germany, Japan, and another team that needs to qualify.
Okay.
Group F, which is Belgium, Canada, Morocco, and Croatia. Group G, Brazil. What is that? Serbia?
What's that? Serbia. Serbia.
Serbia.
Yeah.
Switzerland and Cameroon?
Yeah, Cameroon, yeah. Where Siakam's from.
Okay, Siakam will be playing soccer in Group G. No, I'm joking. Group H. I think Portugal has the most easiest group here.
Okay.
So there's Portugal, Ghana, Uruguay, and Korea.
Okay.
So that I think for that group, I think it's pretty easy for Portugal.
Yeah.
Canada, we're going to have to step it up.
Yeah, definitely.
To be honest, I think we're going to be, if we're in this group, we're going to have to step it up or you're going to be seeing a first round exit.
Yeah, you know, and plus.
No, I'm serious.
Exactly, you know, I'm like,
you're
going to
have to step it up.
The 4-0 victory against Jamaica is cool, but Jamaica's not good at soccer, you know. Like,
yeah.
I showed it to my cousins and like, yo, they're like, they just respond, LOL.
Why? Because.
Yeah,
because
like they know that they're not good at soccer.
What, Canada?
No, Jamaica.
Oh, Jamaica.
Yeah, yo, like one of my cousins, she's just like, yo, it's all good. I'm unfazed. I don't really care. We're not good at soccer anyways.
Yeah.
We're trash. It's like Jamaica, it's like track and field. No one can beat them in there.
No, yeah, yeah.
Soccer, yo, them suck, man. Them trash. Yeah, like legit. Just show them just for fun and whatever. Like, good morning, cuz. 4-0 score, Canada, Jamaica.
Man's throwing in disses.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. What else happened in sports? Not much. Ready for the funny bars of the week?
Funny bars of the day.
Third time mentioned by
Third
Eminem.
Third time by my dad. Calls
Eminem his dad.
By
yeah.
my dad.
Eminem.
My dad. Right here.
He got
my dad.
He got a lot of funny bars, so he's gonna get plenty of mentions for funny bars of the week. But this is the third time.
This is a good one.
This is very funny.
One.
Yeah. This is from My Name Is. And it's just a quick two bars.
Chicka, chicka, my
the
name.
Whole song is funny, but these two, no chill, bro.
Yep.
And it goes like
actually,
this.
Actually, this is the first song.
Yeah, his first single.
His first single.
From his first album.
That when Dr. Dre showed him the sample.
Yeah.
That's when Eminem was like, my name.
And the rest was
and
history.
And the rest was history.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That video. That's what explains it.
Yeah, so here's the bars from the song that are mentioned.
Chicka, chicka.
When I was little, I used to get so hungry, I would throw fits. How you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits. What the fuck, Eminem? No chill, Eminem. What the fuck,
Eminem
Slim Shady?
Eminem still has no chill.
I know, to this day. I know now he would, I know back then, he would have, like, listening to that back then, Eminem would be like, yo, what the fuck was I thinking? Because back then, man was on drugs, yo. To say, my mom got no tits, how she gonna breastfeed me? What the fuck? My gosh, man. But yeah, that was the funny bars of the week, bro. Brought to you by Eminem.
Oh, yes, and it's already posted, by the way.
Yeah, yeah, it's already on the page.
It's already on the gram.
Brought to you by a drugged up Eminem. Drugged up Slim Shady.
Well, people still say he's, people still say he sounds better.
Yeah, yeah, on the drugs than sober.
But to me, the only thing that I say that's better,
yeah,
is he's more on beat, yeah, when he was on drugs.
Yeah, yeah,
his
yeah.
His voice,
yeah,
like, went with the beat. On the beat, he was never off beat.
Yeah.
And then now when he's like yelling, screaming, his like supersonic flow.
Yeah.
You can tell when he's like off beat.
Yeah.
Like I'm pretty sure he knows he's off beat. He just doesn't care anymore.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But like he just wants to like rap as like a freaking supersonic fucking
speed. I know, like, yeah, lyrically, the old Eminem would body the new Eminem, but yep, the new Eminem would wrap circles around the old Eminem.
No, obviously.
You know, like his flow is way better than before he sobered up.
Yep.
You know,
because like, his voice is not like all like raps or whatever.
Yeah.
Like all like that. Like,
yeah,
the,
yeah, yeah.
The young Eminem type voice.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. You know, like with the
Rap-sy
my name
and all that.
Yeah, with the my name is type of flow.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
like basically when you like my name.
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
he freaking like plugs his nose.
Yeah.
Go berserk.
I've been with 10 women who got HIV. I tie my rope around my penis and jump from a tree.
Funny bars for next week.
It's already spoiled.
Chicka chicka. Chicka chicka. My name.
What's it called? Okay, yeah, that's it for today's episode.
Just lose it. Just lose it.
Yeah. I feel on everything but little boys.
Whoa. Don't be saying that.
That's what
guy.
He said. That's Eminem's bars, not my words.
It's your
that's
bars.
His words, not mine. Okay, yeah. Episode 142 is a wrap, yo.
142 is a wrap.
Yeah.
Get your motherfucking podcast.
First
out
episode
your mouth.
Of April, y'all.
First episode of April and the last episode of April.
Yeah, oh no, the last episode of April before we move, before I move.
You, Matt said we move.
Before I move. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, have you still decided? Are you going to be taking...
I think we just leave it here because you never know when I'll pop by again.
Well, you're not going to be coming every week down here.
Oh, no. Every once in a while.
So then how are you going to do it?
Well, you never know.
So you're going to cancel the pod?
Me? Nah.
Oh, man. Yeah, you're 3 hours away. Time difference is different, you know. No, I'm saying, like, if you did,
yeah,
I can give you the old, like, the Steinberg one, the white one.
Okay.
You just have to connect it if you ever wanted to take it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I'm down to take it, sure.
Oh, yeah. Now you're going to take it because
yeah.
I'm offering you the interface.
Yeah, you're actually offering me, so I'll take it.
Why not?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I wasn't going to use it because I don't have an interface, but thanks, Podcast Poppy.
I can use this for my laptop, right? Because I don't have a, what's
yeah,
it called?
Yeah, connect to your laptop. You just have to download this. I think the sound card driver.
Yeah.
And then as soon as you plug it in, and when you go on like Zoom or something.
Yeah.
Instead of your laptop mic, you just have to go to where it will be like the Steinberg something.
Yes. Yeah.
So the Steinberg will be your actual driver.
Okay.
So when you use it.
Yeah. I'll figure it out. Yeah.
No, you won't.
Yeah.
It's going to be like, Matt, just keep
it. Or just use the laptop mic.
You could. You
either
could.
Or. Yeah. Yeah. Just to make myself sound better. I'll try to use this one.
It'd be good when you're doing your DJ mixes too, because you can use this, talk in your mixes.
Yeah, I usually don't talk on my gigs. I prefer to just let the music speak for itself.
No, I know that, but then it'll be like DJ 9-1.
Yeah. I'd rather just, you know, just use the ones and twos.
Manza said the ones and twos. No, I mean like, you know, when you do like your videos on like, because even in like, if you have this, you could do more, you know how, DJ What's Next does?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like stuff like that. How come you don't do that?
Oh,
like
for
live
Twitch?
Mixes and stuff like that. Not even just for Twitch.
Yeah.
Even if you just recorded yourself like doing it, you can like speak to people. Even if you do a live on YouTube.
Yeah.
Or like live on IG. So then you have like a mic.
Yeah.
Instead of, Because, like, if you're not using, like, a... not, it's not, like, a really expensive mic.
Yeah.
But I'm saying they can hear you better with this than if you're not using a mic at all.
Yeah.
But no, I'm just going to let the music do the talking.
Yeah.
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 True.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. 142, we done, y'all. It's a wrap.
We done. And the mic is not working.
Tired, y'all. About to go to bed.
Okay, my guy.
Yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. 143 soon come.
This was the podcast about the Oscars.
I bet Kyle's already sleeping right now.
Hey, shut up.
Let's go.
Let's go home. Farewell.
He's going to keep on by himself.
Got to throw on the end screen, my guy.
Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and
and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud, we're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast.